I got a very, very, very special guest with me here today. Vina Love, what's up?
Hey.
How are you feeling? You know, we're coming off International Women's Day. How have you been? How's everything during, like, how's your 2021 starting off?
Actually, I'm not mad at it. Definitely not mad at it. I've been traveling a little bit, you know, staying safe, but definitely traveling, making a lot of new music. And yeah, I've been good. I can't complain. Can't complain.
So how has the pandemic been for you when making music? Because you've released a few joints over the past year, and obviously, you know, you're now signed to Cinematic, correct? And yeah. How's everything been for you since last March, looking back on the past year?
Well, actually, it's crazy because I was like really, really depressed as soon as COVID started. I was living in New Rochelle and just, I was like right in the heat of COVID, like right.
Oh, you were in like the big yeah. ass quarantine zone.
Yeah. So it was really depressing at first because I couldn't go to the studio, I couldn't record, things like that. But as time went on, like, you know, it started to get a little lighter and I was able to get in the studio. Then I signed my deal and then I was constantly working all the time. So it definitely brought my spirits back up. And now I'm just, you know, I'm working. I'm using the free space of not like constantly performing all the time and like really just getting my music together.
Got you. So when I have to ask, because I don't think I've ever met someone in the quarantine zone from New Rochelle. What was that like for you?
Well, it's crazy because I'm from Harlem. So I'm okay. used to getting up, going outside whenever I want to, stores right there, all of that. But at the time when I was living in New Rochelle, it was just weird. I mean, New Rochelle is really not much of an interactive place anyway. So now with COVID and then you really can't come outside your door and all that kind of stuff, it was crazy. It was definitely really crazy.
But you know what? We're better now. Everything's better. We got, we got the deal, everything going well for you. You know, we got the new single, Owe Me, out now. With this deal, why did you decide to sign this deal now? You know what I'm saying? Because obviously you've had a bunch of records, you've had a bunch of success leading up to this, but why now for this time to kind of partner up with Cinematic?
I feel like a lot of times you get artists who, you know, start their labels and like want to do certain things with other artists and they don't have the knowledge. So they run into, you know, just certain hiccups and like just making terrible mistakes that they didn't have to make. And I feel like when you team up with other people who already know what they're doing, you'll gain the knowledge, mm-hmm. you'll gain all of the connects that you need. You're meeting the people that'll help you be in position to help other people. So why not connect with other people who are just as passionate as you and really have the same interests as you? A lot of people ask me too, like, you were already independent, so why would you like put yourself in a like non-independent situation? But that's the thing. I still have my creative control. I'm able to do the things that I want, do the things that make me feel good with my music. So amen.
I love that. Congratulations on that, because obviously it's such a big moment for you. And obviously we're going to have, like, you know, we got My City dropping soon. Hopefully this month. We got the album coming this summer with My City. What can people expect from this record? Like, is there anything different than what you've done before? Like, what are we doing with this record?
So My City is definitely a vibe. It's crazy because it was written like 6 years ago, going on seven years. I initially wrote it for Rihanna, but then I remembered she's from an island. And then she actually held the song for like 2 years. And then I really don't remember exactly what happened, but she ended up not using it. So I kept it for myself. So I think it's definitely a different kind of vibe. I think it'll put me closer to all the R&B artists that are out now in terms of the kind of music that they're making. Mm-hmm. So yeah, I hope everybody likes it. I think it'd be cool.
That's so funny. You know, we glossed over the Rihanna part of it, which is, first of all, hilarious thinking of Rihanna singing a record like that when, you know, she's mm-hmm. not even from like a major city. With your songwriting stuff, because I know that, you know, you've submitted songs to obviously Rihanna and like Ariana mm-hmm. Grande and the likes of them. With mm-hmm. songwriting, have you had any songwriting records like get out? Like, have there been some any, like, what have you done when it comes to songwriting for other people?
I actually haven't gotten like my big songwriting break, like mm-hmm. they like a celebrity puts out a song that I wrote. Like, I haven't gotten that yet. So yeah, I just keep submitting stuff, like keep working, keep getting better. The more I go into my album, I notice that I'm not the best writer yet. So I'm still learning. I'm still working with other people and like just really trying to figure out my style. And yeah, but I'm not stopping though. I'm still submitting. I'm still like, you know, trying to get that break.
Of course, of course. So obviously we mentioned the debut project. With the debut project, you know, and you brought up how you're learning more and more about your songwriting process going mm-hmm. into it. With the debut project, what are you doing differently on it than what I guess you've done in the past? You know what I'm saying? Like, how is this kind of different mm-hmm. from what you put out before?
Well, initially, it's so crazy because my first album that I made that I was going to release, I did the whole thing with Diz.
Oh, wow.
So he was like, and it was probably like one or two other producers on there, but they were all collab. Like, it was just all Diz's work. So I never really branched out to work with a bunch of producers because I just wasn't there yet. Like, I just didn't get there yet. So now with this album, I'm working with different producers. Nobody has ever written for me before. So now with this album, I have other songwriters and I'm collabing with them, and we're like putting our heads together and making songs. So yeah, the difference is I'm working with more producers and more songwriters.
If there's one thing that Dizzy Banko is going to do, is go and get himself on a collab tape. You feel me?
Oh, like, yes, he is.
If there's one thing he's going to do, he's going to get to the bag and do like a collab, mm-hmm. right? But I think that would be dope because, you know, first of all, shout out Dizzy, man. Dizzy's beats go crazy, man. So I would have loved to see that actually fully come out. You feel me? Like, I feel like that would have been so dope to have y'all on that.
It's so crazy because we was listening to like the first album the other day. And I was like, it's no way these songs could go to waste. Like, it's no way. We got to figure out something to do with them. So I don't know. I feel like, and at some point I'll end up releasing it for like all my older supporters that have been around for so long and they were waiting for it. I think after I drop my album, who knows? We'll see.
Like maybe a B-side situation, maybe on YouTube, yeah, SoundCloud, something, you know, like that.
Yeah.
I feel like that would be dope. Do you have anything working with Dizzy on this album?
I don't, and I want like at least one. At least if we gotta, like, you know.
I'm gonna cut this, send it to Diz and tell him he needs mm-hmm. to get to working, because I know mm-hmm. that the second you call him, he'll get right to cooking for you.
Me and this boy speak almost every other day. But he's really my brother in real life. So we talk about stuff like that. We don't even really get into like the music stuff all the time, but we definitely I gotta remind him of that.
Got you. And you know, I love that for y'all, man. You know, happy, well, I don't know mm-hmm. if this is his birthday, but happy belated birthday.
Yes, Diz, today.
Man. The day that we're recording this is his birthday. Happy belated birthday, Diz. We love you. Mm-hmm. So with this project, is it all you, or, you know, who else is anybody joining you on it? Like, what are you kind of looking at in terms of collaborations?
None, actually. None. Okay. This is all me.
A few years ago, you know, I accompanied mm-hmm. Angie Martinez to this premiere of her show, and of course, Growing Up mm-hmm. Hip Hop New York. And I have to ask you, because as someone who watched that season, what was that experience like for you? How do you feel like? Because I feel like everyone's experience is a little different. You know, I talked to YDB some time ago, like a year and a half ago, when the show premiered. What was your, mm-hmm. I guess, personal experience with the show?
It was very different, very, very different. I mean, I'm a person, I'm full of personality. I like to interact with people, but only in a certain kind of way. If you push my buttons, I don't like that. And that's what reality TV is for. And that just wasn't like my steez. Like, that wasn't my vibe for real. But it was definitely a good experience in terms of like just getting my face out there. Even if people didn't know who Vina Love was or didn't hear my music, at least they heard my name. So like, if they do hear my name again, they'll be like, oh, she's from Growing Up Hip Hop. Let me go check her out. So it definitely opened the door and I ain't mad at it.
Yeah, I love that. And so when we think about, you know, TV and film in the future, is acting something, you know, obviously acting and reality TV are like they're kind of similar, but two different things at the same time. Mm-hmm. Is acting something that you also want to keep on pursuing? Like, would you want to, like, you know, go into like TVs, movies? Like, what are you kind of looking for in like that industry?
It's so crazy. People don't even know. I went to high school and college for acting, singing and dancing also, but for acting also, like Broadway, all that kind of stuff. So I'm definitely into being on Broadway, being in movies. I don't think I'd do reality TV again unless it was like my show about my family, because we're so funny. I think we need a show. But that's it. That's about it. But I'll definitely be in movies and I'll be doing everything. I'll be everywhere.
Yeah, like step by step. Let's get the project. Let's get this project out first. You feel mm-hmm. me? So when it comes to the rest of this year, what else do you have planned? We got the project. We got new singles. What else do you have in store for the people in 2021?
So I have more singles, more videos, which I'm really excited for. I love shooting videos. I love directing them. I love seeing the finished product. So I'm really excited for the videos. And I think the main event for me this year will really be my album. Like, it's been years. Like, I've been holding out for such a long time. So I feel like it's, for my supporters I've already had, I feel like it's highly anticipated and it's just time. So I'm excited.
No, this is very exciting, and I'm looking forward to everything you have coming this year. You know, before I let you go, something I always ask when my New York guests is, so obviously, you know, you're from Harlem, so this is especially for you. Who are some, like, it could be younger, older New York artists out right now that you really want to work with, in whether it be on your next album in the coming years, like, who's out right now that you kind of really messing with lately and really kind of want to, like, you know, just get in the studio with?
Right now, well, I love Chef G and Sleepy Hollow. Mm-hmm. Love them. Even just personality, like, they're just really cool ass people. So I know, send in the studio. Yeah, send in the studio. We're going to make some good ass music. Oh, sorry for cursing too.
No, you can curse. It's all good.
I'm trying to think who else, New York. It's mainly guys. That's what makes it a little crazy, because everybody that's lived from New York is really guys. I feel like it's probably like, there's a couple females that's lit. I mean, London Hill for sure.
Yes, my sis.
London Hill for sure. Connie Diamond. Oh my God, this is crazy. I talk about stuff like this all day and I get in an interview and completely forget everybody.
You're like, you'll be spitting off like dope female rappers all day. And then I ask all you, day. You're like, and you name two, but you definitely have talked about like way more.
Like, what? Talked about so many more, but London Hill, that's my baby. Oh my God. I would like to see how that would work, like how that would sound. Like, that's what I'm curious to see, how our sound would blend together. But yeah, it's a lot of people.
You know what's mad funny? Whenever people talk about London in my interviews, because you know, I got so much love for London. I gotta say, I'm gonna send this to Dizzy and London, gonna get a text from me when this interview drop, because I love London. And I think y'all two on a record would definitely be like a nice balance, you feel me?
Yeah,
because I feel
real vibe.
Yeah, you know, because London got this energy to her, and I think I think when mixed with your singing, that could really be something special.
It's just that, like, it's that Harlem sexy, know how to dress, know how to talk kind of vibe. Like, you don't really get that from women today coming from Harlem. So I think for us, that'll be amazing.
Nah, you know what? I'm definitely going to send this to her, and we're going to make it happen, because that'll be dope.
Yeah, we got to do that.
So before I let you go, obviously videos, album, anything else that people got to be on the lookout for from you this year?
Me, watch me. Watch my Instagram, watch me, because I'm coming. I'm outside, I'm coming. Pay attention and don't sleep on a girl. Don't sleep on her.
Yo, it's been such a pleasure having you today. I'm just happy that we were finally able to get this interview in. Finally got, even though we met digitally, I'm sure we'll meet each other in person one day, but I'm happy that I finally got to make this connection. And it was such a pleasure having you on the show today. Let the people know where they could follow you at, stream your music, any last messages you got. Now's the time. Go ahead, drop that in there.
Follow me on Instagram at VINA_LOVE. You can catch all my singles on Apple Music, Tidal, Spotify, Google Play, all that good stuff. Catch my visuals on YouTube, Worldstar. And yeah, turn them post notifications on. Make sure you're watching your girl. And I want to shout out my entire team. I love you guys so much. And everybody that's out there supporting. Thank you.
Yo. There you have it. Make sure y'all go stream Omi, My City, out soon. And until next time, it's Vina Love on the Radar, baby.